So you've been thinking about selling your house, but now what do you list it for? What is the correct list price? When you are deciding that with your realtor, you should be deciding together. When I'm going into a listing appointment, I never come in with a price because I haven't even seen the house yet. There might be agents that come in there with the range already, which is hard to do when you haven't seen the house, you haven't seen the condition, what it backs to. Does it back to a busy road? Are there updates? So it's very important, in my opinion, that you are talking together. The other important thing are what are the seller's goals and motivations and risk tolerance? And then what I try to do is educate my sellers on the market, analyze the sold properties. What is the condition of your house versus the neighbor's house that recently sold? Price per square footage differences, assessment ratio. You know, how much have the houses in the neighborhood been selling for in comparison to the tax assessment? I don't believe in tax assessment as a way to value, but it's a small piece of the puzzle. So if all the neighbors have been selling for about 110% of the tax assessment on average, if you're selling for 150, it might be off. So it's just something good to look at. Also, the lot differences. Do you back to that busy road or to a water tower, or are you backing to trees in a quiet setting? Those obviously have different values as well. We also want to look at the current real estate market, the supply-demand. That's very crucial in determining the right price as well. We can look at how many are under contract. That shows that there's real buyers out there that have already chosen houses and they're ready to close on those properties. So that is demand. Another way to look at demand is how many have sold in the past 3 months. If there's been a lot of turnover in sales, that's a good sign for a lot of buyers. Obviously, it's crucial that you look at how many active listings are out there. Big difference if you are up against one other property versus 10. So you really have to look at if it's in a kind of buyer's market when they've got a lot of options, it's really crucial that you're picking the right price and you're not going to be overpriced from the rest of the market. But if there's no inventory, then you can shoot for the stars a little bit more. Also going back to look at the sold properties, how many actually sold above list price? If there are a number that have been selling above list price, that's also an indicator that there have been multiple contracts. Again, high demand. The other thing to discuss with your realtor is your risk tolerance and your goals. What is your goal? Do you want to sell it really quickly? I've had past clients that have children at home and they say, "Megan, I cannot deal with having people in my house. Like, I need to make it move and I'll trust that you will get me the best price." So, you know, sharing that with your realtor is really important. Others say, you know, "I actually bought the peak of the market. I'm losing money. It's really important to me that we try to get the highest price and I'm willing to take some risk to, if I don't get it, I know that I will have to probably reduce my price after 30 days," but it is, again, a discussion that you need to have with your realtor. And there are some that, you know, aren't concerned about pinching every last penny. It's the process. They want a smooth process, that it's not going to be a big hassle. They're not going to have to continue to show their house day after day, week after week. So again, important to know what are those goals. If you list too high, though, remember, like I just said, that you might have to reduce the price after it sits on the market. So you could end up netting less in the end. You also don't want to list too low because if you list too low, you could lose money out on the sale because you can only get multiple contracts. I mean, you can get multiple contracts if there's just one, or I'm sorry, you can get more than list price if there's one, but that's not easy to do. It's much easier to get over list price when there's multiple contracts. So it's a fine line and it's important to try to price it right. And to get that multiple contracts and get that highest price, again, I really recommend staging, which you can check out my other blog that gives you some insight on that. But again, discuss these items and agree together on a price with your listing agent. You know, don't choose the one that comes in with the highest price because sometimes they're just trying to get the listing and know once you've signed with them, eventually it's going to sell. It just might sell for a lot less and that's not in your best interest. It's in your best interest to get you the best price, and sometimes that is having to hear the hard truth of the market and your property and what you need to do to get your property in the best shape to sell for the highest price. So if you have any questions, please feel free to shoot me an email. And good luck selling your home.